Hello, so this question is Dota 2 Senate, and then you have two party, Radiant and Dire, and then for each Senate, you can exercise one of the two, right? The first one is going to be ban the other party Senate, and the second one is going to be announce the victory. So what you can do is you give in a Shrine Senate, and it consists only R&D. And then let's just look at the example. So ours comes before D, so ours can either ban or announce a victory, right? So since there is a value D in the Senate, we are not allowed to announce the victory right away. So R can only ban in this situation. So R, Radiant, ban the Dire. So this is no longer in a stream. And then R is the one remain. So in the second round, R, Radiant announced a victory. So what happened to in this case? So R will ban the D, so this is no longer in the stream. All right, so when I traverse the index, so I was here, right? But I banned it. So I moved to another one, which is gonna be a next index. However, the next index is banned. So I moved to another one. So the D will be will have two right. It's either banned or announced. So there is a R in the stream. So I'm going to ban this guy. So I'm the one who is going to be the last value in the Senate stream. So I'm announced victory, Dire. So this question is straightforward. We're using a Q. Q for R, Q for Dire, Radiant Dire, right? And then basically we just compare whoever has the smallest index, who has the right to do the ban or announce victory. So let's just start coding. So Q, integer. I'm gonna add index in the Q. So radiant, R-A-D-I-A-N-T, new linked list. And then what's the other one? Dire equal to new linked list. So the first one is gonna be, I need to append all of the char array. I need to append all of the value in the queue, right? But I need an index, right? So so this index will continue use for the rest of the for loop. So this is why I'm not using the int I equal to 0 for the for loop. So if the C equal to R, so in this case, I'm going to add the radiant index in the queue, else dire.offer i++. Cool. So now every single one has the index. And then since I'm going to, let's look at this. Maybe I need to include the code. So let's look at this. So this is supposed to be 0, 1, 2. And then we know Radiant is going to ban the first D, right? But Radiant is still in the stream. So the next index that we're going to replace is going to be 3, right? So the first one is not going to be used, right? Q can ban index 3, right? So this is the idea. So let's do this. So while the radiant is not empty, and also dire is not empty, we can traverse. So let's think about this. So what happens if the radiant is empty? So if this is empty, we know the victory is going to be dire. Else, Ray, D, Ian. Alright, so let's look at the index. How do we look at the index is going to be peak? Radian dot peak. If the radian dot peak is greater than the dire dot peak. So what this means is the smallest index has a priority. So dire dot offer the index. So I'm going to reuse my value for the dire. So the other case is going to be radian dot offer, right? So since they are comparing and one of them is going to bend the other one, so we're going to pull both sides by one. Why? Because if radian dot peak is greater than dire, and then I already reassigned the value for the dire, so I pull. And then I can use my dire to bend the radian, so radian, you know, get bent, you're no longer in the queue. So this is the idea. Okay, this one here. Submit. Okay. So, time and space. Space is going to be this. The worst case is going to be all of S. You have all of the radian in the string or all of the dire in the string. All right, time, this is all of S. And definitely, there's something less than all of S for sure or equal, right? So, time and space are the same. So, this will be the solution. So, if you have questions, leave a comment, and I'll see you next time. Bye.